Hello everyone. So let's see about the functions. So if you are already experienced with other programming language, you might have called the same thing as like a methods or some other way like a functions also. So let me just define a very layman term what the function is. So let's say your boss will give you some work and same work it will give you every day. So you just bundle those work into one particular code at a one day. Okay, next day suppose the same boss will ask you and give you the same work. So you do not need to write that code again and again. You can use whatever the code you have already written earlier or earlier days, and you can treat those earlier written code as like a black box system. So something, the idea behind this function is like a don't repeat yourself. You just write once and keep reusing those things. So let's say let's take one concrete task. So let's say our task is to print some pandas. So okay, pandas 100 times. So we can simply use like a for loop, and I'm just going to give like a I, or let's give 10 in, let's say range 100, and I'm just going to print pandas. Okay, so it has immediately printed the pandas. Okay, so printed this 100 times this panda. Now suppose someone will tell you to again print this pandas 100 times. So you do not every time should write this code again and again. Instead of that, what you should do, let's just take this code as it is, and let me just go to the another cell. Let me just keep it here. Now if we can just bundle those thing into some sort of, or we can just wrap this particular sets of code into some sort of bundle format. So for that we can use the simple functions. So functions will start from the keyword like a def and print. I'm just going to give the name of my functions like a print pandas. After that we need to pass argument, but here we do not require to give the argument, colon, and I can just write everything whatever I want to write it here. So I want to write this thing, so let me just copy it. Okay, so indentation should be perfect now. So if I just execute it, my print panda function has been created. Now if I just call this print pandas with zero argument in a bracket, it will print this pandas 100 times for me very easily. Okay, so you do not need to write this pandas or same for loop code again and again. Now let's add some more complexity. Let's create another function. So I'm just going to copy this thing again. Let me go to the next cell so you can imagine better. So let's say instead of just printing pandas, let's say print pandas x times. That is our new function, and whatever the x will pass it from input argument. And instead of 100, let's say I will just iterate over this loop x time. Okay, and let me just execute it. So instead of just 100 times, I am just passing one more argument, and if I just print it, let's say print x time. Now I just cannot call it like this, it will immediately throw me error that missing require one positional argument because it is expecting this x variable. So let's say instead of 100, which is some sort of very hard coded and prefix, but let's say if I want to print, let's say 12 times, so you can see it has printed this pandas function 12 times. Okay, if I want to, let's say print just 2 times, so it has printed 2 times. So this way you can get more and more control by passing the argument to this particular functions, and you can define this function once and you can just keep reusing again and again. Now all those libraries and module which is externally written on the top of this Python programming language contains what? It is just containing the set of functions or set of methods, you can say. So let's just take example of, let's say, this numpy library. So numpy as a np we have already imported earlier. Now inside this np It is still not loaded. Yeah, okay. So now load it. NP, there is a number of functions are available. Now, whatever the body, what we can write inside that particular function, you do not need to worry about that, because it is already been written by this NumPy, numerical Python community has returned for us. So let's say I want to use one function like let's say the random. From the random module, I want to use the function like a rand integer. So from 0 to 100, it will just generate any random integer for me. Now, how that random integer will be generated, I do not need to worry about anything, because all those code has been already written inside the library. The idea behind this particular function is write once and you can keep reusing again and again, because this community people has written this particular function rand integer, which is available inside this NumPy library, and the module of this NumPy library is nothing but the random module, has written just the one time, and we can just keep reusing instead of writing all those code which is already written as a part of this particular function. You do not need to repeat all those things again and again. Instead of that, just call it and you can start reusing it. Let's just use some more function. Let's say from the same random module, we can use rand n. So let's say 10 might be, well, yeah, so 10 different integer or 10 different float number between some minus values and plus value it has generated. So random, normally distributed random numbers, 10 different numbers it has generated. So all those code which is written as a body of this particular function, we do not need to take care, and that is what the beauty behind this function. So I hope you get the idea behind what is the function, and that is all about the Python section. And from the next section, we'll deep dive into the different data structures available in a Pandas library.